Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2240, Tips for Customizing the Ribbon. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Last week I was doing a webinar about pivot tables, and you know, one of the things I always complain about in pivot tables is how I hate this compact layout, and I always switch to tabular form. And of course, if you have Office 365, you can set your pivot table defaults now and make that be the default. But in the chat panel, Ronnie W. from Texas said, hey, you can just add this to the quick access toolbar. And sure enough, right click, add to quick access toolbar like that. I never realized that was one that you could add to the quick access toolbar, but now with one click, bam, it's back in tabular form, which is the form that I like. And so, you know, I said, hey, Ronnie, send me a note. I'll send you an Excel guru patch for that idea. And then Ronnie sends me two new ideas, even better than the one he just gave me. Ronnie says, you know, the best thing to do in Excel is to customize the ribbon, and sent me a copy of Ronnie's ribbon setup, and gave me two tips that I had never heard before. Tip number one, I'm always frustrated when I customize the ribbon because I can't seem to have control over whether the icon is large or small. Right? See, you know, you get these small icons, and unless you go into the ribbon XML, you're not going to have a chance to control this. And Ronnie broke the code. He said, look, always make sure that you just use lots of groups, and each group has 5 icons or less, and that'll keep all the icons really large. So, great tip there. And then Ronnie says, make sure that whatever tab you create, you put that tab above the Home tab, and then it'll be the default tab. It'll be the tab that you have all the time. All right, so let's try this. We're going to right-click, customize the ribbon. Okay, so I'm sitting here on the Home tab. I click New tab, and I get two things, both New tab and New group. All right, so you want to go to New tab and rename that. I'll call it the Mr. Excel tab. Click OK. And then with that selected, move it up so it is before the Home tab. All right, then you have your new group here. And we're actually going to have a lot of groups. So this first group, what are the most important things to me? It has to be related to pivot tables. So I'll rename that to be pivot. Click OK. And then we have to find commands to add to that. Now currently, pivot is on the Insert tab. So I'll find Insert, Tables, choose Pivot Table, and then add that. And then what else would I like? If I find, we'll go to Design, and then Report Layout, Show in Tabular Form, click Add. All right, so now I built a group with two items there. And then maybe I want a new group that is my formatting group. So I'll rename, click OK, and back to the All tabs, Home, Font, Font size, I'm always changing that, so I'll add Font size, Bold, I'll add that, Underline, I'll add that. Alright, so there you go. So we have two groups in this case. Group 1 has 2 icons, Group 2 has 3 icons. Take some time, you know, 10 or 15 minutes to create the perfect set of icons for you. If you need to move it to another machine, you can export all customizations and then import on the other machine. Let's see how it looks. Click OK. All right, so we have our new tab, Mr. Excel, pivot table, show in tabular form, the font size, right, and just keep going straight across. All right, so now let me close Excel and reopen Excel and see if Mr. Excel becomes the default. Yeah, there we are. Beautiful. So as soon as I open Excel, it is the default Mr. Excel, and if I need to go find something else, I can go to the Home tab. Oh, yeah, show the start screen when this application starts. So File, Options, General. I have this turned off, so that way I could just go straight to a blank workbook instead of starting at that new Home screen that we talked about yesterday. All right, hey, check out my new book, Microsoft Excel 2019 Inside Out. Click that I on the top right-hand corner for more information about that. Today, wrap up. Build a new tab in the ribbon with your favorite commands. Thanks to Ronnie W. for this idea. Lots of groups with less than or equal to 5 icons each. That makes sure that the icons stay nice and large like this. And then move your new tab above the Home tab to make sure that it is the default. To download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL in the YouTube description. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.